There's a new crisis unfolding in the nation of Myanmar. It's the poaching of Asian elephants. As NewsHour producer Nsikan Akpan reports, this fragile species, which is distinct from its more numerous African cousins, is facing a growing threat.
The poaching of African elephants, where they are murdered for their ivory tusks, is well documented. But halfway around the world in Myanmar, their cousins, Asian elephants, are 10 times more endangered and facing a new serious threat. Poachers are taking the elephant's skin and turning it into ruby red jewelry.
Yeah, it actually was a huge shock. So we were following these elephants with our collars, and we started noticing that they disappeared. The collars stopped working and they disappeared.
Peter Limegruber is the head of conservation ecology at the Smithsonian Conservation Biology Institute at the National Zoo in D.C. His team stumbled upon this poaching crisis during a routine tracking study with GPS collars that started in late 2014.
Well, we had 19 collared, and five of them we knew were poached. We found them poached. And then there were two that disappeared, and the way their movement changed right before they disappeared indicated that they were probably poached too.
This led the researchers and Myanmar officials to collect reports of poaching from local villagers.
So in the end, we found about 45 elephants killed in a very small area, the size of a county.
This poaching was surprising because, unlike their African cousins on the open savanna, Asian elephants preferred the seclusion of the jungle, making them hard to hunt. John McAvoy was one of the researchers in the field.
Even our trackers have to spend hours and hours in the bush, fighting through vines and other vegetation to even be able to see the elephants so that we can put the collars on them.
Prior to 2014, Asian elephant poaching had been relatively uncommon because only males have ivory tusks, and even then, it's a small percentage.
But now that the females and calves are being affected, this will be a very significant impact on the population. It's the surest way to drive the species into extinction.
A separate survey by the Myanmar government reported 25 poached elephants in 2016. Combined with the Smithsonian tally, that's 70 poached elephants over the last 3 years, double what the country witnessed from 2010 to 2014. Due to habitat loss, roughly 2,000 wild elephants remain in Myanmar, so at its current rate, skin poaching could wipe out this population in just over 50 years.
And a lot of the buyers like to buy the original skin, which is sold by weight, because then they can see the original product and know that it's real.
Belinda Stewart-Cox is the executive director of Elephant Family, a British conservation group that specializes in protecting Asian elephants. Since late 2014, Elephant Family has been investigating this skin poaching and the black market trade surrounding it. They found illegal traders in China are the main customers for Myanmar's poached elephants. This matched similar findings made by the Smithsonian. The skin, which can be up to an inch thick when it's removed, is sold in two ways.
Some of those pieces are being cut into cubes, and those cubes are dried and are then turned into beads. Those beads look ruby red because they contain blood. And they're being turned into prayer beads or bracelets or necklaces.
The elephant skin is also ground into powder for pharmaceutical medicine. Both beads and powder are marketed on social media sites like Baidu and WeChat. Chinese officials denied Elephant Family's report, responding via state media that the amount of elephant skin imported into China is very limited. Under international law, countries are allowed to import elephant skin from four African nations, but trading of Asian elephant in any form is prohibited, except in rare cases. To thwart the potential sales of these new products in the U.S., Japan, or other popular destinations for elephant parts, the Smithsonian, U.S. Fish and Wildlife, and groups working in Myanmar are making public service announcements.
Most people that purchase these products have no idea what they're doing. We need to go to the places where the markets are and educate consumers about how damaging the impact is of what they're doing.
If this killing spreads, it could threaten the 50,000 Asian elephants left in the wild. Limegruber said the key is reducing market demand for these products before these animals are all gone. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nsikan Akpan, reporting from Washington, D.C.